everyone, welcome to Educes. This video will help you in understanding the flow of the Educes University Management software. Once we do the setup, you will be getting the login credentials, username and password to the registered email ID or the mobile number. If you does not receive the credentials even after the setup is over, you can reach our support team. Also, you can create your own password using forget password option in the login page. Now, use your browser and enter the URL as www.educes.co to open the login page. You use your credentials to log in into the application. So, let us start with the flow of the application. We need to go to the University Masters, application settings, department and designation. In the department and designation, we have department screen where we can add all the department present in the institution like IT department, accounts department, etc. First, we have to configure academic batch. Staff student cannot be registered without academic batch configuration. First step, academic setup. Go to academic setup, academic setup, open the batch icon. Now configure the academic batch, select academic degree, degree group, etc. from the existing drop down. If the exact degree group is not available, click on the degree group button. The degree group button is present in the main window right corner and configure the degree groups. Select batch from year to year as their batch slash college duration. If degree course is to be managed by a specific department, then select specific department like EEE, ECE, IT department, etc. in the drop-down list of managed by department. This is optional. If course slash degree is MBA specific accreditation, then only checklist OBE specific checkbox. Academic year table will be enabled based on the selection of the course duration shown from year to 2 year selection. If degree is semester wise, we can split the year into semester by just checklisting the checkbox is semester wise. And select the number of semesters from one academic year. Max semesters will be 5 in a year. After that, we can give the start date and end date, start time and end time of the academic year. Once the semester settings are done, then set the year type of generated course year. We can have 3 years type, namely current year, previous year and next year. Let us take an example. For 2019-23 batch, the first year will be 2019-20, academic year will be current year. And for the second, third and fourth years will be next year. For 2018-22 batch, the first year of batch 2018-19 will be previous year. And for the second year, 19-20 will be the current year. And for third and fourth, it will be the next year. So choose accordingly. Hope you understood. Once the academic batch is configured, then current year will be reflected in the blue color and the previous year will be reflected in the pink color and the next year will be reflected in the green color. If your institution has many specified setup of roll numbers, then you can expand the prefix in roll number, prefix column. Also, you should set the maximum length of roll number. There should be at least 3 categories, difference in roll number prefix and roll number max length. You can give even the max credits for one semester slash year, minimum pass credits which is to be gained by the student for promotion to next year. Permitted backlogs for the year can also be configured. Also select the shift type for the particular academic batch. We can also create academic batch through bulk import option. We can download the Excel sheet and can maintain the data in the particular format, and we can upload all the data at a time. In load Excel sheet by giving details in the mandatory fields, we can create new academic batches. Mandatory columns headings are in green color. Optional fields can also be filled if data is available. Once academic batch creation is done, then you can register the staff in staff registration in the user management module and student in the student admission screen in the university setup module. Next step, student admissions. Go to university setup, user registration, student admissions. In this screen, we can add the student admission details like personal details, family details, language proficiency, admissions enrolling information, uploading the document submitted by the student at the time of admission, etc. Any number of students can be registered based on the availability of the seats, and these data can be modified by the school or college or university officials at any time. Once the application status of student is confirmed, no changes can be made in the admission information. However, we can use student management screen for adding, updating more information of the student. Click on Add User plus icon to add the student admission details. Enter all the required data and save the data in the field to register the student. Asterisk symbol fields are mandatory. It's optional to fill data other than the mandatory field. In enrolling information, we can be select the student admission info such as for which academic year they are enrolled, degree code, course year. Student photo can be uploaded using upload photo option and document using upload document option in the same screen. Transportation and dormitory facility can be assigned to the student by enabling bus and dorm facility. By default, we will be providing one application type in the drop-down. If you need more types in the drop-down, just configure in the master setting screen by selecting inquiry types. Similarly, while selecting occupation types in the family details, to get data in the drop-down list, you have to add new types in the master settings. Once the application status is confirmed, a notification will be sent automatically to the registered mobile number or email IDs that registration has been done successfully. To get a notification to the student, we need to configure one-time configuration. Just go to Application Master, Notification Templates. You can select in a default template on student registration and create the template whatever you want to and just save it. Or else you can give the default template name as well, and you can use the template columns provided in the left side and create the template. Save. Then go to Notification Alert Master. Here you will be configuring one-time configuration with what type of notification the student has to receive and how he has to receive, like through SMS or through push, internal mail or external mail. Just select here and just save it. Then automatically the student will receive the notification. Hope you understood. Next step is staff management. As a super admin, you will be assigning the work to the different staff according to their roles and designations. So now we have to go to Department and Designation screen. Configure the departments and designation before registering the staff. First, department configuration, which we have explained initially. Next, we have to create designations. Here we can add all the available designations in the designation alias. Also, we can configure teaching plan details for the staff in the staff management screen. Only for those job designations has ease teaching option enabled. Next, we have department designation mapping screen. Here you need to map under which department the designation should be. Next step, the staff management. Go to user management, staff management. This screen is used to register the staff. Enter all the required data and save the data in the field to register the staff. Star fields are mandatory, it remaining all are optional. Staff can be assigned to the department based on their specifications. Management can register the staff just clicking on add single user button beside add user. Use bulk import option. If there is a large number of staff, make sure Excel sheet is in the proper format to ensure importing the data without error. You can even download the load run report to check the error for failed records. You can make appropriate changes for the failed records and reload or import again. While registering the staff, if you have not specified the genuine email ID, then application will generate automated mail ID for each staff. You can reset staff password on the user maintenance screen. Next step, role authorizations. Role authorization screen. In this screen, we can give access for the screens to the users based on their user role in the branch level. We can give an access to read-only and read-and-write for the selected screens. User role-wise access. Custom user authorization. Here, we can give access to the screens username-wise by choosing the departments for the selected modules and screens. Username wise or the individual faculty wise. Now, let us go back to academic setup to complete further configuration. Academic setup, go to academic setup, subject management. In this screen, we add list of subjects for the individual course years belonging to the respective degree codes. This can be done individually by selecting plus icon and enter data for the required fields. You can select the subject type as elective or non-elective. Based on the subject, we can keep the subject groups as 1, language 2, etc., which can be selected from the drop-down list. To include one particular subject into timetable, then enable include in timetable option. You can also specify number of credits for that particular subject. Make sure that total credits of all the subjects assigned with the course year should not exceed the maximum credit count of that particular course. If management has decided to assign different subjects in one time slot, then include those particular subjects into different groups. We cannot include theory or other subjects into groups. Management can also update the number of hours to be spent for each subject. Then spent hours will be updated automatically for classes or courses have been taken or completed. Create subject details can be edited using edit option in the action column. Management can also delete multiple subjects at one time. Management can also dump all the subject list at once using an Excel sheet present in input. Fill all the information in the Excel sheet with given format and upload the process the file. Then all the subjects will be dumped into the screen, which takes less than 5 seconds. Management can view the count of the success records, failed records, and total records of the file. Note, even student admission is confirmed, they need to be assigned to a particular section, then only we can see them in the student management screen for any data to add or reflect to the students. So now we are going to do section management, then student to section management. Section management. In the section management, we create number of sections for the particular degree code or course year. They can also define the maximum strength maximum students to be allocated to the sections for the created sections. For one course year, duplicate sections are not acceptable. You can configure the sections by clicking plus icon and enter data in the mandatory fields. Primary and secondary course year faculty, class teachers can also be assigned to monitor the students in the sections, optional. Secondary faculty can act as a backup in the presence of primary faculty. Next step, student to section. After sections are created, now in this screen, we assign the students to respective sections. In student admission screen, once student admission is confirmed, then student will be reflected in student to section unassigned screen. You can see unassigned students for the selected degree code and course year. To assign all the students to the sections at a time, then checklist which is available in the selection column. If you want to assign few students to the sections, then enable the checkbox for individual student. After selecting the student, now select the sections from allocate to the section drop down and save. This is the flow of the application of university management software. Thank you.